Step forth, fellow voyagers, into the cavernous realms of bygone wisdom. Before us lies a cryptic expanse, where whispers of ancient intellects linger in hallowed echoes. This, dear seekers, is the sanctuary of lost philosophies. The forgotten doctrines that once carved the destinies of empires and cultures. Are you prepared to unearth the buried? Ponder for a moment. What would it be if entire ways of thinking, grand tapestries of cosmic understanding, vanished into the sands of time, only to be replaced by newer, shinier ideologies? From the annals of history, many a luminary has shone brightly, only for their teachings to be obscured by the mists of time. In the vast Indus Valley, scholars professed ideas about the cosmos and our place within it, ideas now lost to antiquity, overshadowed by the more dominant Vedic traditions. The Manichaeans, followers of the prophet Mani, spun intricate tales of light and dark, good and evil, in a cosmic dance, only to be silenced by the more potent voices of monotheism. As the world turned, thinkers like Hypatia of Alexandria championed Neoplatonism, blending the best of Plato with Eastern philosophies. But, with the rise of the dogmatic and the fall of the Library of Alexandria, her ideas, too, became mere embers in the philosophical night. The debate rages on. Were these teachings truly forgotten? Or were they deliberately relegated to the shadows, deemed too revolutionary or inconvenient for the narrative of ruling classes? In the silent theater of existence, philosophies are the scripts, some celebrated in grandeur, others forsaken, left to echo in the corridors of oblivion. Why should we care about these lost voices? These forsaken scripts of yore? Because, kindred souls, they remind us of the fluidity of knowledge, of the impermanence of even the grandest of ideas. They implore us to question, to seek, to challenge the status quo. In the quietude of reflection, entertain these musings. What invaluable insights might we unearth if we dared to excavate these buried perspectives? How might our understanding of the world shift if we integrated the wisdom of the forgotten with the knowledge of the present? Could it be that in the vast tapestry of philosophies, no strand is truly lost, but merely awaits rediscovery in a different hue? Let these questions be your lanterns as you navigate the shadowed corridors of lost wisdoms. For in understanding the forgotten, we gain deeper insights into the impermanence of thought and the cyclical dance of ideologies. May your journey through the labyrinth of lost philosophies be as enlightening as it is evocative. Until we converge once more on the shores of inquiry, remember, in the ebb and flow of wisdom, nothing is truly lost. It merely awaits rediscovery by those bold enough to seek.